So students, now we will discuss parts of a flower. You have to be very attentive and listen very carefully. And please learn how to draw parts of a flower. Listen, the stalk of a flower. The stalk of a flower, we join the flower to the plant, to the stem, to the branch. That part is called pedicel. Pedicel is the stalk which joins flower to the plant, you can say branch or stem, right? Now see, over this pedicel there is a swollen portion on which entire flower rests. This swollen portion which bears all part of a flower, this portion is called thalamus, right? And here you can show the green leaves. Before blooming into flower, it's the initial state of a flower is called bud. You have seen bud of a flower? It is covered with the green leaves. So when these green leaves separated out, then colorful leaves comes out and flower blooms. So when flower is not in blooming state, in the initial state, the flower is called bud. So in a bud, you have seen the green leaves. These green leaves, these are called sepal. So when the flower is in bud stage, these green leaves, they provide food to the initial stage, that is the bud stage. These sepal green leaves, they produce food. They are green, they can do photosynthesis, and sepals, they perform photosynthesis for the flower. So the green leaves of a flower are called sepals. Now see, the most beautiful part of a flower are the colorful leaves which we call petals, right? So the most beautiful part of a flower is the colorful leaves of a flower which we call petals. So till now we have discussed three important parts of a flower. Stalk of a flower, we join the flower to the main stem or branch is called pedicel. Pedicel connect the flower to the plant. Green leaves of a flower are called sepal, and the colorful leaves of a flower are called petals. Petals are colorful and attractive. They attract insect for pollination. So we will discuss further what is pollination. Before that, we learn about the parts of flower. I think this is clear to you. That stalk of a flower is called pedicel. Green leaves on the flower are called sepal. And colorful leaves of a flower, they are called petals. Now, you know that flower is the reproductive part of a plant. Rest other part of the plant are called vegetative part. Root, leaves, stem. These all are vegetative part of a plant. But flower is the reproductive part of a plant as it produces seeds. And seeds give rise to a new plant. Flower is considered as a reproductive part of a plant. It has male part and female part. First we will discuss about female part and then male part. In the center of a flower, there is the female part. So, female part of a flower is called pistil. This complete is called pistil. Now, the three main part of a pistil is upper part of the pistil. I have told you that female part of a flower is called pistil. And the topmost part of this pistil is called stigma. And this long tube is called style. In the lowermost swollen part of the female part, this swollen part is called ovary. This is called ovary. Inside the ovaries, there are small beads like structure. These are called ovules. So these bead like structure are called ovules. So this is about the female part. Flower has two part, male part and female part. In some of the flower, both the parts are present together, and in some flower only male part is present or female part is present, right? So the flower having both the part, male part and female part, that is called bisexual flower. And if a flower have either male part only or female part only, we call it unisexual. So there are two type of flower, bisexual, in which both parts are present, male part and female part both are present in one flower, then it is called bisexual flower. So I am drawing here a bisexual flower. I am showing both parts in one flower, female part as well as male part. For example, China rose, for example, mustard. In these plant, flower have both part, male and female part. So it is called bisexual flower. So here I have told you about the female part. Female part is called pistil. What do we call the female part of flower? Pistil. Female part of a flower is called pistil or carpel. Clear? So pistil or carpel is the female part. You can call it pistil, you can call it carpel, both are same. So the female part of a flower, it consists of stigma, style, ovary, and inside the ovary there are ovules. Now I will draw the male part. This is the male part of a flower. So students, male part of a flower is called stamen. So male part of a flower is called stamen. Stamen has two main parts, anther and filament, right? So anther and filament are the two main parts of a flower. Anther and filament together they are called stamen. These together they are called stamen. So now you have learned different parts of a flower. Let's understand them once again. See, the stalk of a flower is called pedicel. Green leaves present on flower, they are called sepal. The colorful part of a flower, these colorful leaves of a flower, they are called petals. The most beautiful part of a flower is petals. We like the petals, right? The colorful, attractive part of a flower are called petals. Now, a flower has male and female parts. I have shown both the part in a single flower. So, it is a bisexual flower. It is showing male part as well as female part. Now, let's discuss that female part. It is in the center of the flower and it is called pistil. Completely as a whole, we call it pistil. We can also call it carpel. Pistil or carpel, they are the female part of a flower. Now see, female part has three main parts: stigma, style, ovary. Inside the ovary, there are tiny beads-like structure. They are called ovules. When ovules mature, they form seeds. And when ovary it get mature and ripen, it forms fruit. Right? So that we will discuss later on, but here you have to understand first the main parts of a flower. So female part is called pistil. It has three parts: stigma, style, ovary. Inside the ovary there are tiny ovules here, and the male part, it is called stamen, and it has two main parts: anther and filament. So anther and filament, they are the two main part of a male part. We call it stamen. Stamen is the male part of a flower. Anther and filament are the two parts of that stamen. Clear everyone? So now let us recall the green leaves present on a flower. They are called sepal. The colorful leaves of a flower, they are called petals. The female part of a flower is called pistil or carpel, and the male part of a flower, it is called stamen. Clear? Stamen, it has two parts: anther and filament. Pistil has main three parts: stigma, style and ovary. So when ovary get mature and ripen, ovary store in some of the plants, ovary store food, it get mature and ripen and give rise to fruit. So what is fruit? Fruit is a ripened ovary. Fruit is from ovary. So fruits, they comes from the flower. Flower, in flower, ovary, it mature and ripen and form the fruit. And thus ovules, ovules which are present inside the ovary, they give rise to seeds. When the ovule get mature, they form seed. I think now it is clear to you that when ovary get mature and ripen, some of the ovaries, they store food. They mature, they ripen and form the fruit. And ovules inside the ovary, they mature and give rise to seeds. Now, it is clear to you that ovary give rise to fruit and ovules give rise to seed. So, flower is very important part of a plant, and flower give rise to fruits and seed. It is the reproductive part of a plant. I hope everything is clear to you. Even then, if you have any doubt, you are free to ask me on my personal number. Today, your homework will be to draw the diagram of flower and leaf and show different parts of leaves and flower. Right? Thank you.